These closures happen because there's poop in the water. That's really what it all comes down to. We measure bacteria concentrations in our samples as an indicator. Is there poop in the water, and if so, how much? More bacteria means more poop, and more poop means that there's probably more germs in the water. The poop can come from people, it can come from pets, or it can come from wildlife, like geese and ducks. And with these bacteria concentrations, we don't know what it's from. All it tells us is that there's some poop in the water, and there's a greater risk of getting sick if you go swimming. Juanita Beach is a special beach. It used to have a lot more problems in the past, but Kirkland Parks has done a lot to really improve the beach and reduce the bacteria getting into the water. So a few things at Juanita. We like to swim at Juanita because it's a nice protected cove, but that also means the water doesn't circulate through and flush out the bacteria. The cove keeps a little warmer, better for swimming, also better for growing bacteria. The geese and ducks like Juanita Beach as well. Sometimes they're the source of the poop and the bacteria. Sometimes people will bring their dogs to the swimming beaches and that can cause a problem. But also, swimming beaches get bacteria from the people that go swimming there. We all think about the toddler with the leaky diaper, but it's all of us. So it's important for everyone to just shower off before you go swimming. And if you do have toddlers or babies, make sure they use a high quality swim diaper. Again, just help keep poop out of the water. Juanita Beach is affected by Juanita Creek. When we talk about people, pets, and wildlife getting poop in the water, we tend to think about right here at the beach, but it can also be upstream getting into the creek and then from the creek into the beach. So when Jean samples Juanita Beach every week, she also samples Juanita Creek so that we know, is the bacteria coming from the beach area or from upstream in the creek? Whenever we close a beach, the first thing people ask us is, was it a sewage spill? That's also the first thing we ask. So we work with the sewage utilities and ask them if they've seen anything that there was a problem. And it's almost never a sewage spill. They're really good about detecting those and responding to them quickly. So when we find high bacteria concentrations, we always check for a sewage spill, but it's almost always something else. It's just from people or pets or wildlife at the beach, or at a beach like Juanita, from people, pets, or wildlife upstream of it. So when we do find high bacteria concentrations and public health recommends closing the beach, we start gathering more data to figure out what's going on. Jean and our field crew, every time they're at the beach, they're always looking around for possible bacteria sources. We ask the beach managers and the lifeguards what they've been seeing. And we also do some more tests. Jean will come back a second time that week on Thursday, collect a second set of samples, so we start getting more frequent sampling to understand what's going on at the beach. We'll also run some additional lab tests that we can actually look at genetic markers to see, do the bacteria come from people or from dogs? And if we need to, we can send it out to another lab to look for geese. So we can start doing some more tests to ask, where is the poop coming from? What's causing these bacteria? And getting more information, trying to find the problem, working with our partners to identify and fix the sources of why poop is getting into the water. When the beach is closed, public health always recommends do not swim, do not wade. Some of the ways you can get sick from water with high bacteria in it is actually skin rashes, irritation of the eyes. What we worry most about is people actually getting water into their mouths and swallowing it, and then you can get nausea, diarrhea, vomiting. But when there's high bacteria, because we don't know what kind of germs it might have, we always tell people don't swim, don't wade. Certainly don't put your head under the water. Kirkland Parks has been doing a lot to improve Juanita Beach, and we have seen far fewer closures than we used to have in the past. The city, when they redid the park, looked at a lot of how water drains, tried to make sure that, say, goose poop on the lawn doesn't just flow right into the beach. They opened up the dock to improve water circulation so that when bacteria does get into the water, it can wash right back out. So the city has been working a lot with that, and anytime we do have a closure, the city is always a very active partner with that. What's going on at the beach? What did the lifeguards see? What's going on at the creek? Do the city stormwater folks know about anything? Because the poop can come from so many sources, there's a lot of people who get involved in trying to find it and fix it. Everyone can help by keeping poop out of the water. We recommend four main things. One, don't bring your dogs to the swimming beaches. It's not allowed in Kirkland or in most cities because dogs carry poop. Two, don't feed ducks or geese near the beach. Ducks and geese poop a lot, and if you feed them, you attract more of them, and that's just more poop in the beach. Third, if you have a toddler or a baby, use a high-quality swim diaper. Keep that poop contained. And for all of us, number four, shower, rinse off before you go into the beach. People always have just a little bit of poop on our bodies. That's how it is. And when you have 3,000 people a week using a swimming beach, that can really add up.